Alright, so welcome back to part 2. Okay, so in this series we're going to create a turn-based RPG battle system. If you don't have this file, there is a link down in the description below, so download it. Let me run this to see where we stopped yesterday. Okay, so we're displaying the player's health and the enemy's health. Okay guys, this is probably a good time to smack the like button and maybe leave a comment. Say anything, say potatoes or something, I don't know, say something. Okay, so let's begin. Let me open my objects. Let's go to code, and the first thing we're going to need is a new variable. All right, let's make a new variable. Let me zoom in here so you can see what's going on. Let's make a new variable. We are going to call this player attack. Okay, we can set this to 0 at the beginning. Let's draw the variable. I'm just going to, whoa, wait a second. Red health and red health. This should be called green health, actually. Green health. My mistake. So let me just copy this here and paste it. So we can call this player attack, and it's gonna be equals player attack. All right, so we're going to display this at maybe 20 on the X and 20 on the Y. Try out. That should just read 0 now. There it is. Player attack equals 0. Okie dokie then. Back to code. Let's make our first step event. Step events happen all the time. Okay, so whatever you put here keeps happening during the game. Where are my icons? There we go. Let's see, let's find on mouse down. Okay, so if that happens, we are going to set our attack variable, or player attack. Player attack, we're going to set it to 25. Okay, let's try it out. Okay, so let's click, and you can see that player attack turns to 25. So let's make an if statement. If player attack it's greater than 0, we can decrease that variable. So we'll set that player attack minus 1. Try it out. Let's click on it, and you can see that it returns back to 0. But if you keep clicking, you can see that it gets stuck at 25. Okay, so mouse down is only going to work if player attack is equal to 0. Just drag that in here. Okay, so if player attack is 0, then we can click. Okay, try it out. Let's click. And now you can see that it doesn't get stuck at 25. Okay. Let's do some damage to the enemy. We are going to need a new variable. Let's go create. Just drag variable. And let's call this player damage. Player damage. Let's set this to 0. Let's go to step event. Let's go to the top. Yeah, we're gonna set this variable to random range. So it's gonna be player damage. We're gonna set it to random range. Let me zoom in. It's gonna be from 0. Maybe from 1 to 10. Your player is level 1 right now, so it shouldn't be able to inflict so much damage. Okay, let me display the variable. Back to draw. Copy this. Paste it. And this will be called player damage. This will be player damage. Display this at 40 on the Y. You can see that the player damage is now fluctuating from 1 to 10, which is what we want. So, let's go back to step event. So when we click, we want to decrease that variable. Let's set green health, which is the bad guy's health. We're gonna set it to green health minus, say, 5 for now. Try it out. You can see that his health goes down by 5. But we want it to go down randomly, okay? So let's use our random number, which is player damage. Let's try it out. Click. 93, 83, 74, 71, and you get the point. That one only did 1 damage. 58, 53, so it's not consistent, okay? As your player levels up, you can increase the damage, okay? So you can make tougher enemies. Alright guys, we're gonna leave it at that. Try this out. And yeah, don't forget to comment down below. And yeah, I mean, just say anything. I mean, say bananas, potatoes, or yeah, I like pie, it's cool. Alright guys, see you in the next episode. Smack the like button.